on this computer. Okay, here we are. So today I will talk about the next module that is about the linked list. Anyone in this room who have known about the name linked list or you have used linked list before, please press one in the chat box. If you could remember last time when we finished studying the CVE 100, right? And I have ended up with the data structure, and also I talk about the pointer to another node. So sometimes when we instantiate or initiate a variable, that is the structure variable, and then if you have defined the pointer that point to that node, right? So we can call it as the referential pointer. So and from that information or that concept, right, we are going to talk about this into detail today, right? I will start from the easiest one or the simplest one, right? If you could remember last time we talked about the array, right? We have used array in many occasions. For example, if you want to keep the scores and the information of the students and you want to use it later, and then you have to calculate for something like grade average or the summation for the score of the students, right? The number of the students. So you have to create an array in order to keep or store the value of score, right, in the array. But you have known that array is not convenient sometimes. Maybe it will quite rigid or not flexible for inserting or deleting an element from the array. So the linked list will be the choice for solving this problem. Okay, for today's class, we will talk about the linked list, the definition, and how can we understand about the linked list, and also the application. And because there are so many classification of linked list, for example, singly linked list, circular linked list, doubly linked list. Actually, we have also the circular doubly linked list as well. So today we will talk about these three or four kinds of linked list. And then I will end up with the header linked list and how to use the multi-link matrix, right, in many applications. And I will also talk about the applications of the linked list. This is all the topic that I will talk today. Okay. I have asked you about who are family or you who have known about linked list before. Please press one right to the chat box, so I can count the number of the students who have known about the linked list before. No one? Yes, there is one. Only one person. Amazing. Two. Some students who are good at programming, or you have the experiences in participating POSN camps, right? Maybe camp two or more, you might be familiar with the linked list, because the linked list is also an appropriate data structure that you can use for storing the a sequence of information, right? And if you want to manipulate the linked list, that would be easier than the array, right? For example, in the sense that you want to insert or delete the information or the node from array. Okay, first of all, I would like to start from the definition of linked list. When we talk about linked list is a linear collection of data elements, right? The data elements, is this concept is the same as the array, right? These data elements can be called nodes. Okay, sometimes we will call these kinds of the data structure together with it link, right, as a node. Okay, linked list is a data structure which can be used to implement other data structure. For example, stack or queue, right? Instead of using a simple array to implement the stack or queue, right? We can also use the linked list as a data structure, right? In order to make it more flexible than the array. But we can also use array for the stack and queue, right? We'll talk about that later in the next chapter. And the last one, a linked list can be perceived as a train or a sequence of nodes. Okay, you can think about it as a train and a sequence of nodes in which each node contains one or more data fields. And another one is a pointer to the next node. Okay, maybe you cannot imagine about this from the textual information, right? Maybe I will show you in the term of the figure. From this figure, you can see that this is a kind of data structures we can call linked list that I have already talked about, right? The linked list can, okay, from here, you can see that this is a node. This is also a node as well, right? There are nodes. There are many nodes, like 7 nodes connect to each other, right? How can we know that they are connected, right? Because we have the link, right? The first node, right? There are two elements, right? The first one we can call the data, right? This data can have, there might be one or more data fields. Do you remember data fields? Data field is like the attributes of the data structure. For example, if you want to store the student information, okay, if you just collect only name, right, so there is only one data field. But if you want to collect names, family name, and age, right, maybe there are 3 data fields. So, and I will group this information into one, right? I will just group it and think about it as an information of this node. And we also have another important element that is a pointer to the next node, right? This one will be the pointer, as its name is point to the next node, right? So if I want to know about what is the next node of the node 1, so it will be 2, and what is the next node of the node 2, it will be 3, and so on, right? So what is the last node, right? The last node will be 7, but how can we know that it is 7? Anyone in this room can answer my question? Okay, we have John, Theo, Para, right? Mm-hmm. France, right? What does it mean by this one, this node? How can we know that this one is the last node of this link? Okay, maybe you can see that this one is X, right? It seems to be like a spatial character or something, right? I would say that in linked list, if you want to say that this one is the end node of the linked list, we will keep this one, this element as a noun, N-U-L-L, N-U-L-L here, can you see this one, noun, N-U-L-L, noun, means, actually it will point to the zero address. But the zero address for the C programming is just like now or just nothing, right? They will point to, but nothing in this case will be the last node. So in order to check for the number or to count the number of the elements in the linked list, so we can just simply traverse from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, right? And once the next node of the element point to now, a null pointer, sometimes you can call it null pointer. So you can say that this is, will be at the end of the linked list. Okay, and sometimes if you want to specify the first element of the linked list, so you may have to provide the a specific node that we can call the start node, right? Start node will refer to will point to the address of the first node. Okay, once again, when we talk about the linked list, right, you have to deal with the pointer, and also you have to deal with, when we talk about the pointer, it's an address in physical memory. So you have to take care about you have to take care of it carefully, right? So I will tell you into detail later. Now next pointer. Next pointer is equal to now, right? There are some answers from your friends, and that's right. This one is a now pointer, or the pointer to now, or the pointer to the zero. Normally, when we declare now is I'm not sure it is the constant or the defined, right? But it is provided in standard.io.h, right, for now. Okay, here we are. So this, when we know that the representation of the linked list can be figured as this picture, right? So in order to implement this linked list into a C programming, or C programs, right? What we have to do is, if you could remember, you have to define it as the struct. Okay, struct is an abbreviation of the structure, right? So here we want to define as a new structure name, right? Name node, structure node, right? And braces, right? To say that this is a body of the structure, this structure. Okay, in this structure is a very simple data structure. It contains the first one is an element. The first one is a field of information, actually data, and define it as an integer, as an integer. And then the next one is a struct node. And next, you can see that this one is an asterisk sign. What does it mean by asterisk sign? It is a pointer, right? Next is a pointer to the structure node. So simply speaking, if you are the professional programmer, you might think about this as an address or the physical memory, right? So in this way, this is the way that we are going to define a link, right? A link or a pointer to the variable next of this data type. So you can see that during this declaration, right, you can also define itself. Sometimes it's called this one as a referential element, if you could remember, right? Referential element means this one could be the structure node, right? And it points back to itself, right? It can be a pointer to itself. This is a way that you can define in C, right? C programming, you can define a linked list easily like this. Structure node, right? And structure node pointer next. So in this way, you can, okay, this is an example of the implementation of this simple linked list. For example, if you have the main memory like this, right? To contain data of integer, there are 4 bytes for integer, and the next will be the address in main memory. It depends on the the size of the memory, right? It could be say 4 or 8 bytes, depends, right? So in this way, we get the first node, right? That is a start, and start have the link to the address of the first node, right? And the first node will contain the data edge, and then the edge will point to the next node at the memory location 4, right? I use 4 in order to be the easiest way to represent the address in main memory, right? So in this way, if you have this for 4 bytes and this for 4 bytes, right? This one maybe start from 0000, so the next address would be 0008, 0010, why 10? Because 16 can be wrap around to the hexadecimal value. It will be 0010. Okay, and then so H will point to the next node will be the node number 4, right? And the node number 4 will contain E, right? And E will point to 7, and L, you can get L, right? L to point to 8 is L, right? It's a hell, right? And then L point to 10, hello, okay, right? And then minus 1. Sometimes we can define now as a minus 1 or the end of linked list. So it depends. In conventional, now will be 0. But in this case, right, the now value or the last value of this array or this linked list, sorry, not array, this linked list will be minus 1. Okay, so this is an example of how to represent the linked list, right? Okay. This example is to show about the linked list as well, right? So we have to starter points, right? So starter links, right? And they share the same area of physical memory, right? So in this figure, it will explain you about two linked lists, which are simultaneously maintained in the memory, okay? So we can say that in memory, that we cannot just allocate. Okay, this one is for the link 1 and this one is for the link 2, right? It will be mixed up, right? But your program have to click or have to keep track on the address of the main memory. Depends upon the data structure type, data structure length or the size. Okay, for this example, from biology, right? We'll start from S01, and then you can help me to turn on microphone and say something, right? Biology will point to the first one, the first data element, S01, and then 3, S03, and then to 8, S06, and then 11, S08. And then 13 is 10, right? And then 15, so S 11, right? So that this will be the end of the this will be the end of the linked list. And for start 2, right? Okay, we'll start from S02, and then S0, S0 to 5, like ring to 5, and 5 node will be S0 4, right? And link to the node 7, and S0 5 will be the next node, right? And then 10, S7, S07 and 12, S09 and then N, right? So S09 will be the end of this linked list. Okay. Okay, these are some examples of linked list that maybe you can see, right? And this one is also the bigger information, right? This is about the, for each node, right? It will contain about the student information. For example, the roll number, the name, aggregate, the grade, right? And the next node, right? So this is the same thing that I have just told you, that the data element, it should be one or more fields. Okay, here we have to, before we go to the type of the linked list, I would like to wrap up about the pros and cons of the linked list and array, right? I put two stars here because you should know about this one, the comparison of linked list and array. Both array and linked list are linear collection of data elements, as just told you, right? It's linear. It perform in linear manner. But unlike array, right? A linked list doesn't store its nodes in consecutive memory location. But for array, right, you have to store the node in consecutive manner in the memory location. Okay. In physical memory, right? But linked list doesn't, it doesn't matter. You can store the node separately, right? In the main memory. Another point of difference between the linked list does not allow random access of data. Okay, linked list you have to access one after another, right? Contain from the link to the to the next node. But for array, right, you can calculate for the random access location of array, right, because you have known in advance about the size and also about the location of the first or the best memory of array, right? And array is stored in the sense of the consecutive memory locations, so you can guess the address of array element. But not like linked list, right? Because linked list you have to access in a sequential manner, so you cannot use the random access to the data. This is a similarity between the linked list and array, like insertions and deletions. Operations can be done at any point in the list at a constant time, okay? At a constant time. But this point is important. The advantage of linked list, right? That is that you can add any number of elements into the list. But for the case of the array, right? It depends on the size of an array that you have initialized. Right. If you initialize the maximum of the array for 20 data memory, data elements only, you cannot add it up. Add it to 21, 22, right? Except for Visual Basic, right? You can do it like when you define dim, right? Dim to define array in Visual Basic. And you can redim, right? To redefine the dimension or the array of the content that you are going to store. But for linked list, but for C, right, you cannot do that, right? If you define, you have to define the maximum as big as much possible, right? But if you go to the maximum of the data elements, you cannot add more element to the array. But for linked list, you can do, right? You can add any number of elements into the list. It's up to you, up to until the size of the physical memory. So we can say that the linked list provides an efficient way of storing related data and performing basic operation, right? The same as array, right? For example, insertion, deletion, update of the information. At the cost of extra space required for store the address of next node. What does it mean by this, right? This is, you have to put two star here. If you understand it, right? If you go back if you go back to this array, right? If you want to keep this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 like as an array, the data structure or the memory memory size that you would have to do or to allocate is for integer 1, integer 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 to 7 only. But for linked list, right, even it is more flexible than array, right? But you have to trade off with the link or the memory location that you have to keep track the next link of each node, right? For example, you have to add up one more field in order to keep or to store the link to the next node, right? So this one is a trade-off for the linked list and array, right? So that's why we call, right? The cost of extra space required, right? The cost of extra space for storing the address of the next node or the link, okay? Okay, up to now, do you have any question? You can type or you can turn on your microphone and then ask me. Please feel free to ask me. Okay, if you don't have any question now, I will continue with the first one, that is a singly linked list. Singly linked list is what I have just already talked to you. That is about, this is a linked list with a link to the next node, right? So a singly list will contain some data and a pointer to the next node of the same data type. Okay, it needs to be the same data type. When we say that the node contains a pointer to the next node, it means that the node store the address of the next node in this sequence. Okay, so in this case, right, what is the value that we keep here? Integer one, right? But what is the value of here? The address of the next node. Right? For example, if you allocate this one as a next node, right? And it will return the address of this node. So the address of this node will be kept in this element or this field. Okay, well, there is a question. There's a question in the chat. If we wanna use the linked list, do we have to use only struct or it can be anything else? You can use only structure, right? Structure, or we can also use union. Union is another type of structure, but it will be like flexible than structure or struct. Struct, if you define a field, or if you define a list of fields, you cannot change it, or it cannot be flexible. But for union, you can randomly use the fields, right? According to the union declaration. So if you want to design a linked list, you have to use the struct. And the link to the link to another structure or another node, it should be defined the same as that struct, at that structure. Okay, come back to singly linked list. A singly means single or one way, right? So in this way, a singly linked list will allow the traversal of data only in one way, one direction. For this example, if the start from 1, right, and then to 2, to 3, to 5, right, because we already have the link to the next node, right? So we can call this kind of traversal as a one-way traversal. So this is a simple algorithm to describe about the algorithm for traversing a linked list. Okay, first of all, the first step, right, you have to initialize by set pointer of PTR is equal to start. Start would be an address in main memory that point that is the address of the first element in linked list. For this example, the start will keep the address of the node 1. Okay. Then step 2, repeat step 3 and 4, while pointer is not equal to now. Okay, you have to traverse until the pointer goes to now, right? But if not, right, you have to step, you have to perform step 3 and step 4, right? The step 3 is a apply process to pointer data. So in this case, it doesn't matter that there is only one data or a few more data in the data in the node, right? You can apply the process to that data, right? But in order to access to it, you can use pointer and you use a hyphen and greater than sign, right? This one will be represent to, instead of using the star sign and dot, right? Star sign and dot will be the representation of the link or the pointer to access to the data, right? We can put the star sign to the pointer in order to make the pointer to be a structure or a value, right? And then you can access to it, right? Dot notation in order to access to the element, right? For this example, it's the data. But in C programming, instead of using star dot, right? That would be confusing, right? So you can use hyphen and greater than sign in order, it look like the link, right? So it means that pointer to data, so you access the data, and then if you want to move on, right, to the next node, right, the most important instruction that you may have to use, that is a pointer equal to pointer link to the next, right? Pointer is equal to point next, so we are going to traverse from one node to another node, right? And then we can go on and traverse along this linked list until the pointer points to now. And then you exit and end of the loop and exit. This is what we call the algorithm for the linked list traversal. Right. Thank you, Silit Nawakun. Silit Warakun. Okay. This is what I'm trying to say, right? Pointer data is equal to star pointer dot data. Mm-hmm. For me, in my opinion, I like to use this one. Actually, this is just an algorithm, but this pretty much similar to the C programming definition of the how to access the data in linked list. Okay. Mm-hmm. Thank you for your kind typing to explain about my explanation. Okay, this is a traversing. So I will go to the next example. If you want to print out a number of nodes in a linked list, what shall we do? Right. So first of all, you have to set the count to 0 and then do the same thing as the previous in the previous algorithm. That is to set pointer to start. And then repeat and why. Repeat why pointer is not equal to now. Not equal to now, right? And then set count is equal to count plus 1. And then set the pointer to the next. So this algorithm will keep track on counting the number of elements in the linked list. And then when we go to the last node, right? When the pointer is equal to now. Right, so you will end up a loop and then write the count to show that the number of the elements in this linked list, and then you can exit. Okay, this is an algorithm in order to print the number of the nodes inside in a linked list. What if you want to search for a value in a linked list, right? Suppose you want to find the number 6 in this linked list, how can we do? So we can do the same thing, like you have to start from the pointer from the start and then try to traverse. You can use the traverse, the linked list traversal algorithm in order to do the loop, right? But inside the loop, right, you have to check whether the value, if the value is equal to pointer data, then set position to pointer and then go out of the loop and exit. But if not, you can go to the next or travel to the next node, right? So this is the if else that you have to put inside the loop, right? In order to check for the data, if you can find or the that position, the current position, is the data or the value is the same as the value that you are trying to find or to search. So we'll stop and then set the position to this pointer, right? But if not, you have to keep moving, right? Pointer is equal to pointer dot next. Okay, this is a straightforward value. Okay, this is a figure. Figure 6.11 is if you want to search for the value 4. If you want to search for the value 4, right, this is the flow of this algorithm, right? Okay, the head of this pointer or this linked list will point to the value 1, right? You have to check if value is equal to pointer data. No, 4 is not equal to 1. So you have to set the next pointer to the pointer next. So what is a pointer next? Pointer next will be next node, will be 7. 7 and 4, no, it's not equal. Right, so we have to move on to 3. And 3, no, 3 is not equal to 4, and then move on, right? How to move on? Pointer is equal to pointer link to the next. Okay, now we are here at the node with the data 4, right? And the data 4 is equal to the value that we are searching, right? So now the pointer will be point to this address or this address of this node, right? So what shall we do is, so we have to keep the position of the pointer, right? So position of the pointer will be equal to the pointer that is point to the node of 4, right? Since pointer is, okay. Pointer to data, okay, is 4 and then it's equal, then pointer is equal to PTR. PTR is the current node, right? And then when you can find the value that you are trying to find, so then you go to the step 5 and then exit. So now you can print out or you can go to the correct place. Okay, this one is just in case that you can find the value, right? The exact value that you are trying to find. What's happened? What will be the result of this algorithm if you cannot find 9 in this linked list? Okay, a question, right? My question is, if I want to find a value 9 in this linked list, what will be the result of the position? What is the result inside the post? Now or not? Now. Any answer? This chat, please help me. Why now? What is the value inside the PTR and what is the value inside post? Can I repeat the question? Okay, for this example, the value for can be searched. But if I just want to search for a value 9, what will be the result? What will be the data in the variable post or the variable PTR? Hello, are you still with me? Why you are so silent? Right. Okay, the answer is the PTR will be equal to now because this loop, right, this loop will be end up with now, right, when pointer point to now, right, but in this case, right, 5 and 2 to now. And then when you go out from this loop, right, normal loop termination, you will go to step 4 and then position is set to now as well. So the result of the condition or the situation that you cannot find this value, this given value, the position will be now. So you can write another statement. If position is equal to now or the pointer is equal to now, so you cannot search for this particular value. That's all. Okay, so considering this algorithm, it is concerned to be true, right? For the case that you can find the value or the case that you cannot find the value. In case that the value is cannot find or is cannot found, so the position will be now. Thank you, Seo. You wrote this one to the C programming. Okay, thank you. Return now. Yes. Okay. So, if you have you have known about the basic concept of the linked list, for example, if you want to access or traverse to the linked list, but the most important operations that you might have to use for the linked list will be inserting and deleting, right? So for just the operation insertion, right? There are 4 cases for inserting a node into the linked list. So we can separate into 4 categories that are inserting a new node at the beginning. And case 2, the new node will be inserted at the end. And the 3rd case, the new node is inserted after a given node. You have to find a given node first and then insert a value after a given node. And the last one, you have to insert before a given node. So what will you do? So starting from the first one is the simplest one, right? If you want to insert a new node at the beginning, for this example, you can see that the linked list will contain the link like this, 1, 7, 3, 4, 2, 6, and so on, right? But if you allocate a memory of a new node, right? And initialize data to be 9. So you will have this node 9. Okay, there is no connection, no link to this node. But if you want to insert this new node at the beginning, so what you will do is, because start will point to the first element, the first node, right? So in order to add this new node to the first node, right? What you have to do is you have to use start, right? So start have to point to 9. Okay, but you have to keep track on the link of the previous start, of the previous start. So what shall we do? Okay, in this case, you may have to, okay, the start will point to 9 and 9 to point to start. No. Okay, you can see that this one is the original link list, right? Where the start point to 1. So in order to make this node to point to 1, well, what is the address of 1? Anyone can tell me? What is the address of this node 1? Because we are going to use that address to keep in the link or the pointer element of 9, right? The node 9, right? Do you understand my point? Do you get the point? So if I know that the address of 1, right, I will keep it here. So 9 will point to 1 automatically. 9 will point to 1 automatically. So you have to know the address of 1. And from this example, the address of 1 is start. So what you have to do is you have to store this value with start. And then after you store this value to start, then 9 will point to 1. And then you have to move start to point to 9 instead. So you can have this new linked list with 9 is inserting at the beginning of this linked list. So this is the figure, right? But if you want to convert into an algorithm, so first of all, you have to, if a variable is equal to now, then write overflow. If you cannot allocate new node, then write overflow and then step 7. But just in case that you still have the main memory, the memory, right? You can allocate memory, then set new node is equal to a variable, and then set a variable to next. What does it mean by available? A while. If a while. This is the empty address for the new node. Okay, step 2, we will have to, when we allocate new node, right, and new node have to be set to available, or you can put anything, any information inside this new node. And then avow is equal to available.next. Okay, just forget it. We're just concerning about the new node, right? What will be kept in the new node? New node, you have to keep data, right? Which is a value, right? That is in this case is 9, right? New node point to data is equal to value, and new node point to the next will be start, right? New node point to start, to the place that start, or the start, the main memory, the memory address of start. And then start new point to new node, and then so on. Okay. Okay, this is inserting a new node at the beginning. That is pretty easy. Okay, so we will go to another one. That is if you want to insert a new node at the end. So for at the end, right, you have to allocate the the new node first, and then you have to traverse along this link list until you go to the now, right? To now value, right? So you are at the end of this link list, okay? So if you have to start this pointer, you traverse along this one, right? The pointer will traverse along until the pointer to is to now, right? So what shall we do? So five will point, the pointer of the node five will point to the one, the new node, right? That we have just already allocated. And then that's all. So in this way, you have a trick, right? Because you have to know that the new node, it has to be the last node, right? Because it has to be the last node. So we have to initialize it as the value and now. So in this way, new node will be value and now, will be set to value and now, right? Why do we have to set the next node to now? Because we are going to know that you know that it would be the last node or the we put at the end of the link list, but the property of the node at the end of the link list will be the pointer will point to now. So you have to set up it up as now and then value. And then you have to repeat the step, right? Like the link list traversal, pointer to start and then pointer next is not equal to now and then go on, right? Traverse until you go to the point that the pointer is point to, the pointer to next is equal to now. Okay, the pointer to next is equal to now and then you go out of the loop. Okay, and then pointer dot next, and then you assign with the next the new value or the address of the new value, and then you can get this node 9 to linked to this linked list. Okay, this is inserting a new node at the end. Okay, that's why I have to teach you about the traversal of a linked list. Okay, so when we know how to traverse along the linked list, so we can just modify this algorithm to insert a new node after a given node, right? So on the left hand side, this is the algorithm to insert a new node at the end, right? But if you want to insert at a particular location, in this example, you have to insert a new node after a given node, right? So you have to do the linked list traversal, and then p pointer data is not equal to num. P pointer data is not equal to num. You have to continue performing a traversal. But if you find the data, right, that is equal to num, then p pointer node dot next will be pointed to new node. And new node will dot next, the new node next will point to the current pointer. What does it mean by the current pointer? Okay. From this figure, right, you have to traverse until pre-pointer, you get 3. If you want, oh, okay. I forget to tell you the condition of this example. Suppose you have the linked list like this, and then you want to insert the data 9 in between right after the node 3, right? So you have to traverse until 1, 7, 3 until you see 3, right? And 3 will be p pointer. Why do I have to use p pointer? Because p pointer will point to the pointer that is before the new node to be inserted, and the pointer will be the p pointer dot next. Okay, once again, so we have to keep track 2 pointers at a time, right? The first one is p pointer and the next one is pointer, because what we have to do is we have to keep track on the linked so we can link or connect the node properly. So in this case, like we can go, okay, you can see from the DS algorithm, you have to set p pointer to be equal to pointer, and then you move p pointer along with the linked list, right? P pointer is equal to p to pointer, and then pointer will be moved to pointer.next.Until p pointer data contain the number or the value that is equal to the value that you are going to find and place the new node right after this node. So right after this node, so you will have p pointer here and then pointer will be here. So once you can find the correct position that you want to insert a new node to the linked list, so what shall we do?What shall we do is end out of the loop p pointer.next. What is p pointer.next? P pointer.next is here. It will be point to new node. Okay, that's why I put p pointer.next is equal to new node. It means that, okay, this statement, it means that p pointer will point to new node. Am I right?Am I right? Okay, once again, when you can find the p pointer and pointer here, right? And then you want to insert a new node in between. So what you have to do is you have to store the link of the p pointer with the new node. So that's why I write p pointer.next is equal to new node.Simply speaking, it means that p pointer point to the new node. Am I right? Anyone who cannot understand this step, please press 2 so I can understand and I will explain again. Okay, for this one and then new node, right? New node is free now. So you have to point to the place that the pointer link to. So new node dot point dot next will be store the pointer. Okay, that's all. This is a trick of performing linked list or inserting a new node after a given node. So you have to go on and then try to find the correct position. And then why do we have to keep track two pointers? Because the first oneis the new node, the p pointer, you have to keep track that you have to point to the new node. And the new PTR or the pointer, you have to keep track for the new node link. New node has to link somewhere, right? Otherwise you will lose off the link or the address. So this is why you have two pointer.Okay, so you can do similarly to the case of if you want to insert a new node before given node, right? Before given node, okay, before tree, right? So what you have to do is you have to check for the pointer. If the pointer data is not equal to num, then you can do the loop, right? And similar things you can do, right? And then you can use p pointer to point to the new node, and then the new node will point to tree.According to the pointer that is very similar to the previous case, that is the way that we are trying to insert a new node before a given node. So this is the fourth case. Okay, so I think it is 1 hour. So maybe I will let you have a short break for 10 minutes and then we'll come back and starting for the deletion of a node in a linked list, okay?We will meet again at 2:50.